To me, Ireland is my mother. Always has been, always will be. Because the first time we ever visited Ireland was because of my mother. And we were obviously very, very young at that time. And it was all a brand new adventure. Because we're obviously used to what we're used to. Next minute, we're getting in the car or the train, getting on this big vehicle, which we had to wait for hours. And then we're on the sea, on this big boat, looking at the waves. And it was all so brand new and exciting and amazing. And then you get to Ireland and you think, what just happened? And because it's so late, obviously, you fall asleep in your mum's arms. And then they put on some of the craziest music I've ever heard in my entire life. Irish music from the 60s and 70s. And even as a child, because you're so used to the music you're used to, when you listen to this new music, you're thinking, oh, this is crazy. But it's such happy music. I'm sure there's different styles, but it was so different. My mum was the type of lady, the type of mother, like all mothers, I hope, that used to walk me to school each school day, then appear and walk me home. My dad had the car, and that's what my mum had to do. It didn't matter whether it was raining, snowing, thunderstorm, flooding in St. Asaph. That's what she would do every day. And in many ways as adults, until we have children, maybe we don't appreciate that as much as we should do. And obviously I appreciate that now that I've had a chance to think about it. Time on the boat that I got lost. Now you think it's quite difficult to get lost on a boat, but for a child that young, you walk around a corner and you're lost. And before you judge my mum, I moved very, very fast. Always have. Always will, I hope. And someone on the boat with a cap, I remember the cap coming along and saying, are you lost? And, yeah. And obviously I was crying. Was I crying? I don't know. But he took me to my mum and my dad. And I put my arms out to my mum. And I cried. I cried. Because I was so happy to see her again. And that's a valuable lesson for every child. Because although you move fast, stay by mum. It's just easier that way. I remember my mum taking us to Dunn Stores all those years ago, and I think I needed the shirt for some of the offence or anything, and I remember being so bored as a child, because time is a thing that doesn't seem relevant. 10 minutes is 15 days to a child. I remember on my last visit, which was a month ago or so, I saw the store, or a store, and as soon as I saw the name, I just remembered. I remembered those times with my mum in Ireland. Returning to Ireland this time was difficult, but I got a chance to see some beautiful, beautiful places, because each other time I either didn't have a car with me or it's with the family, and so there was no time to actually explore the beautiful place. I've been to a lot of places, and there's far more to go, but I don't know whether it was the day, it was the weather, but some of the scenes I've seen are so beautiful. And maybe that's because of my heart. Will always be there. Thank you. just before Christmas. We had some news that my mum wasn't well. She'd fallen over. And although she was diagnosed with A, it wasn't that. It was something else. Now, as a child, in some ways you can prepare yourself. Because you can say, and your parents say to you, we're not going to be here forever. And my mum used to say to me, Damian, you must stop being so independent. Let your mother help you. But what my mum didn't realise, she's helped me every single day because she's always been there for me. She's always been there for us, my sister and I. And to hear that your mother has stage 4 cancer of the brain and only be given 4 months to live, it's difficult for every single person. Difficult might not be the word, because as children you always think your mother is going to be there forever, but she's not. So every chance you get, you spend with your parents. You call them, you speak to them. Have no regrets. Four months came and went. During the 4 months, I visited my mum. And I always tried to smile. Because that's what I'm supposed to do. I'm her son. I'm supposed to smile. And be brave. No matter what affects me, I'm supposed to be brave in front of my mum. Because if I worry, my mum worries. And so I walked into the room, and my mum was being assisted with her eating. And I said, hello, mother, how are you doing today? You're looking beautiful as ever. Because she was. Because she's my mum. She will always be beautiful. And her eyes just widened so wide, and she was so happy that I was there. And she smiled, and she said to the lady, no more food. She smiled. And something inside of me broke that day. Because we both knew, and neither of us were going to say, that things were coming to an end. And I sat next to my mum, and a little tear fell down the side of her eye, to her face. Just one tear. My mum was strong all the way through to the end, because she didn't want to show or give her children any pain. In return, we were strong back. We always smiled, held her hand, kissed her face, her cheek, and watched her leave this world. And we will never forget you.
Always well.
to my sister and I when anyone ever mentions Ireland. Ireland is my mum. She's Mother Ireland. We will never, ever, ever forget you. Because we can't. Because our blood is your blood. Which means everything. And we love you.